In the deafening silence of the Quinta del Sordo, Goya splattered his dining room wall with a spine-chilling scene of unspeakable violence. A crazed, mythological god devouring the body of his own son. Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to About Art. For those of you who are new, my name is Tatiana, and on this channel I talk about art from all over the world. I am currently in Rome, which has just gone back into COVID lockdown. So this week, in light of quarantine and isolation, I thought I would look at a work of art that was produced in solitude. Now, the work of art also just happens to be one of the scariest paintings ever produced in the history of art. So come along for the ride, if you dare. It is hard to encapsulate the horror of this scene. Gruesome doesn't even begin to describe it. Let's start by addressing the subject matter. The painting depicts a well-known Greek myth. After overthrowing his father, the Greek titan Cronus, later known by his Roman name Saturn, was told a prophecy that one of his sons would do the same to him. Now, in order to prevent this prophecy, every time that Saturn's wife bore a child, he would eat it, devouring it whole in one bite. At some point, his wife managed to hide away their youngest son Zeus, also known as Jupiter, who ended up fulfilling the prophecy and exiling his father, thereby ending the reign of the Titans. While the myth in itself is disturbing, Francisco Goya has heightened its gore, rendering it as a haunting, visceral, cannibalistic nightmare. Saturn's hands sink into his child's spine. He has already devoured his child's head. His gaping mouth is about to bite off the left arm at the elbow. Blood oozes from his child's neck and runs down his arm and shoulders. The body of Saturn's child is mature. Rather than depicting a child in line with the myth, Goya has depicted one of Saturn's children grown up, a mature human who is no doubt aware of his horrible fate as it was happening. Goya also diverges from the myth by depicting Satan devouring one limb at a time, as opposed to swallowing his child whole. In doing so, Goya has made the murder horrifically slow. Goya has also added a psychological element to the protagonist of the painting. Saturn is not depicted as a mythical titan, but as a frightened, crazed monster crouching awkwardly in the dark. His angular pose, disheveled hair, and wide, bulging eyes suggest a crazed frenzy. They communicate fear and shame. Goya has depicted a creature desperately trying to salvage his own fate by enacting an unspeakable crime that scares even himself. So Saturn's tight grip on his child's body implies a ravenous hunger, as well as desperation, fear, and an awareness of his own gruesomeness. But aside from the gore of this painting and its exploration of insanity, perhaps the scariest fact about this artwork is that it was never intended to be seen by anyone. Goya was not commissioned to paint it. He painted it for himself, for his own contemplation. This is the ultimate example of art as expression, as creative release. Now you're probably thinking, what on earth prompted Goya to paint such an image? I'm afraid I don't have a conclusive answer for you. The Spanish artist painted this scene towards the end of his life. Now, in order to even begin to understand his state of mind, we have to go back in time. Goya, born in Zaragoza, Spain, had a happy and untroubled childhood. After studying painting in Zaragoza, Madrid, and Rome, he worked at the Royal Tapestry Factory, where he created Rococo tapestry cartoons depicting genre scenes of nobility and peasantry that adorned Spanish stately homes and palaces. He then became the court painter for King Charles IV in the royal court of Spain. Then, things started to go downhill, especially under the oppressive reign of Ferdinand VII. Goya personally witnessed his country fall apart under the Spanish monarchy, then again under Napoleon's army, and then once again with the restoration of the monarchy. Moreover, in 1793, at the age of 46, Goya was ravaged by an unknown illness that left him completely deaf. It has since been speculated that the cause was lead poisoning from his own pigments. With this sudden illness and the many political upheavals, Goya's art took a dark turn. Goya began to see and paint his country with a forbidding clarity. Goya's series, Los Caprichos, is composed of etchings of tragic and comic beasts and creatures that criticize Spanish society and reveal a grim social truth. Following his invasion, Napoleon brutally killed those who resisted his campaign. The bloodshed and brutality of the Peninsular War scarred Goya. He made a series of sketches entitled The Disasters of War, portraying the brutalities of war and violence. At the age of 72, a disheartened, fragile, and lonely Goya withdrew and isolated himself. He bought a farmhouse on the outskirts of Madrid called the Quinta del Sordo, the Villa of the Deaf, after its previous owner. Goya, at the time, was also deaf. In the solitude of his new home, Goya, unprompted and of his own will, painted 14 murals on the interior walls of his home. At first, Goya painted luscious landscape scenes filled with blue skies, frolicking animals, mountains, and flowers. But then, he changed his mind. The landscapes were overthrown by images of darkness, horror, insanity, and doom. They feature nightmarish figures executed with dark oils emerging from the darkness. Their sadistic faces stain the interior of his dwelling. These paintings were a turning point in Goya's life, as well as in the history of art. None of them are signed, dated, and none of them were given a title. Goya never mentioned these paintings, nor wrote about them, and they weren't even discovered until long after his death. They include a ceremony enacted by witches and a satanic goat, a dark and gloomy pilgrimage, and a lonely dog ominously submerged to its neck in an ambiguous, muddy mire. They have come to be known collectively as his black paintings. Saturn devouring his son, a scene of unspeakable cannibalism, was painted in the dining room, almost as if in an act of twisted, satiric humor. There are a lot of ways to read these paintings. Are they Goya's way of exorcising his own demons, or what he considered to be the demons of his country? Do they depict Goya's greatest fears, his own nightmares? Indeed, the figures seem to have been painted with quick and hurried strokes that suggest the immediacy of nightmares. Their forms are at times barely painted, almost as if Goya was struggling to remember the clarity of his nightmares, but was able to capture the feelings of terror, desperation, pain, hopelessness, and doom that they awoke. Saturn's own body is distorted and parts of him appear to be melting off. We only get a sense of his monstrous form, just like the elusive memory of a nightmare. Perhaps they are Goya's portrayal of what he considered to be humanity's true nature and the horrors we are ultimately capable of. His figures can be seen as caricatures that encapsulate the stupidity, cruelty, and violence of human nature in times of war, oppression, sickness, and famine. Some scholars have read these paintings in light of Goya's own life. Two old men in particular could be interpreted as a representation of Goya's own deafness. This particular painting has been linked to Goya's life as a father of many children, somewhere between 5 and 20, and his implicit feeling of guilt at the fact that only one survived long enough to become an adult. But the child in this painting is no child at all, but a mature human. This has led others to consider the mural as a metaphor for Spain itself, an autocratic state whose pursuit of power destroyed its own citizens. Others still read Saturn as a representation of the French Revolution, and even Napoleon himself. I personally believe that this painting, and his black paintings in general, are the creative releases of a man aware of his impending death, disillusioned by society, broken by the trauma of war, and defeated by illness and the suffocating silence of his own deafness. I see them as a necessary creative and therapeutic release that allowed Goya to expel and exorcise his own traumas. His son Javier has talked of his father's pleasure in viewing these paintings every day, which he had painted freely for himself. But then again, we will never know the true story behind these paintings. And that's okay. Sometimes no interpretation is needed or wanted for a work of art. Just consider this painting. Consider how it makes you feel. This painting, together with his other terrifying and disturbing murals, are ultimately what helped Goya escape from his own insanity. All right, there we go. That is everything from this week's rather morbid vlog. If you enjoyed learning about this disturbing painting, give this video a big like and share it with a friend. And also tag me on Instagram with a story showing your absolute favorite painting or print by Goya. As always, thank you ever so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.